back with a different phone.
We have the vertical electroscope down here. Can you light that up for us? You lit it up before. Did anyone go into the next cell at all?
Yep.
You did?
This one?
Yep. Yep. Alright, we might head into that one. Go and see what you can get in there.
You.
You. You're going to get me. Okay. Bring it on.
Transferring to a different cell.
Do we have anyone in here that would like to communicate with us? Yes, we have numerous devices around. Are you male?
Ask.
Ask. I'm asking. Are you male? One flush for yes, two for no. I don't like the sound of low flies. Oh, yeah. So did you answer whether it was a male or female? Did it
flash? Yeah, it came at one flash.
One. So you are male. Can you light up a device again for us?
Yeah, okay, too.
Because I'm getting stuff. It's got a heartbeat.
Do we have any female inmates in here?
Yeah, you have a young male in here.
A young male?
There you are.
Baby.
I just don't want to close it too far. Just because I can't open it, I thought I can't even.
Keep getting the words over and over. Didn't do it, didn't do it, didn't do it, didn't do it.
Were you innocent? If you're innocent, set the REM pod off, please.
Just get chills.
Innocent until proven guilty is what the law states. Although I think they like to brand people guilty before they've been.
Back in that time, it was a different.
Yeah.
So he's younger?
No, it's a different time.
Different time? So what era would you think?
I get he's intelligent and maybe wearing a suit.
A suit? So early,
early 1900s?
Yep. Were you in here because you were drunk? Flash once for yes, two for no. wasn't here from his drunk cells, yes.
Yeah.
It's a widow debtor.
He's going no now.
When they got to the centre, not the top.
So what happened?
He had it up light there. See, it's lighted now, it's lighting up.
Yeah.
There's a red triangle there and it's in here. Something's in here.
Yeah.
Mm. Smack in the centre room now.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Do you like us in here talking to you?
There's a compass on the outside.
Yeah.
I think, yeah.
No.
Yes.
Do you want us to leave?
No, it's moving across to the wall. Yeah. Mm.
I
don't
know what
that's doing now.
Gone.
Disappears, gone.
Mm-hmm.
It's gone.
Yeah,
yeah,
okay.
It felt like it was, yeah, it went from the centre of something to
a. You can talk to us.
He was standing in the toy stand when I walked in before.
Standing here?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Floating around. Mm.
It's a little bit.
Do you not have much energy? You can come talk to us. We're not biased against you. We want to talk and communicate with you. Because we'll listen. If you tell us, we'll listen. We're not like the people back in those days that were judgmental.
He doesn't understand why he's in me. That's all he's got. That's all I've got.
So trying to tell us why you're in here.
Moving back and forth around,
yeah.
Just sort of in
yeah.
front of everybody, just checking them all out.
Just come in the center right here, yep.
Yeah, and then just head back to the center.
Yeah.
And sort of
do you want us to move? Would you like us to leave?
Energy building.
Mm. Bigger.
Yeah.
Two.
Yeah. Alright, what we might do is we might move into the other cell and see what we can get in there, where the Chinese writing and stuff is.
Yeah,
just there.
Yeah,
it's supposed to be dropped.
They're fairly tough K2s. The millimeter, I'll run.
Chinese that were in here that wish to communicate with us or any inmate. Yes.
Yes.
That's awesome. Are you the one that did the inscriptions on the wall there?
Yes.
That's pretty amazing that you did that. No? Is it telling us a story?
Mm.
We'd love to know what that story is. The vertical. Mm. Thank you for doing that. That was awesome. Could you do that again? Could you light the vertical up for us again? We also have another device there. There's a big stick sticking out of it. Can you touch the stick for us? If you touch that, it'll make a noise and let us know that you touched it. Were you taken from the gold fields and brought here? It was a hard life on the gold fields. Were you taken for something you didn't do?
Need to swap.
Sorry?
Don't send a message, you need to swap.
Okay, apparently we need to swap people.
You're on?
I'm on.
Alright, so I'm just going to hand over to that lovely specimen of a human being.
Oh.
That's a liar. Alrighty, we'll see what we can get.
I'm going to get you at your worst angles now. I'm going to film you from below. Like this. Oh, wow.
Yeah, it sort of surprised me. But it also means that they're all in really good order. Like, you can do it, I guarantee it's not the original floor upstairs. So, yeah, I really like it. You know, it's really nice.
It's
cool, yeah. Jump back into our questions again. So now Aaron's actually doing our live stream, so I can relax a little bit. Let's back up to last time. I'll go straight into question 5, which is how can we improve our lives? And for those that didn't know the tour last night, I work on a mediumship level, so it's basically relying on the intuition feelings that you get touched, spoken to, hear something, feel an emotion. The vibe, to quote the castle, the vibe, it's Marvo, yeah, all that sort of thing, and go from there. It's specifically your light and truth.
It's got this weird line across the things of all the little gaps in the doors.
Oh, okay, yeah.
So nothing paranormal, people. It's...
I really like it now. I think that's a really nice energy.
It does.
And I think a lot of that ties to the fact that, yeah, the police were issued a horse. And obviously they were born with that. And so you actually formed a relationship.
Yep.
So yeah, it looks really nice.
Definitely.
But generally humans tend to be nicer to animals than they do to each other, usually.
Yeah. Yep.
feeling anything cold, warm, or anything like that?
Nothing out of the ordinary.
It just feels like a weird place. Which makes perfect sense, but yeah.
Yeah, sort of no nonsense, just. You can also kind of imagine it being quite busy in here.
Yep. Yeah, certainly more so in the earlier years. Does everyone feel the same way I do? This is just a calm place. Certainly, probably the biggest thing I pick up on, I reckon, is that relationship between the police officer and the horse.
Of course.
They could come here and it didn't matter how bad a day they had out there, just come in and spend some time with the horse and doing that whole brushing and all that sort of stuff. It's funny because it's just polar opposite energy to particularly the cells. Courthouse as well.
I guess, things in the cells and the courthouse would have had the potential to be quite chaotic. Having, worked in that industry can vouch. It has the potential to be quite chaotic, but then you come out here and you've got your horse that's probably pretty predictable if it's been chosen as a police horse. Brush it. Like you said, spend time with it.
Yeah, it's almost a bit soul-setting.
Yeah, calm. And it's a fair way away from the rest of the bullshit too.
The next question was, what is your most important personal message to us? And things I ask the question and I immediately just get it. It's to try and enhance what you're feeling. I think that is the biggest message here. Is to, despite what goes on around you, you can actually find some calm. That's calm within yourself.
Okay, it's a hot spot right here, right? I can't work here.
A high spot or a hot spot?
Hot spot.
Oh, okay. You've been over there for a
I really want to climb that ladder and I really want to climb that ladder and
you want to?
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
Is it blocked up at the top? Dang it. Anytime there's a ladder or a you know, a trap door or something like that, I'm intrigued. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, Yeah. We went up there. Yeah, the lady as she was leaving, the lady that unlocked for us. She we said, you know, is there anywhere that's off limits? And she's like, oh, going into that public gallery is not recommended. And we're like, that's not,
it's not
no.
Yeah, I still doubt very much that that was actually public gallery.
Yeah. Well, I guess it makes sense, but I mean, but also doesn't at the same time, if you know what I mean. Like, you know, it'd make sense because men probably would have been the main ones that would have been coming to watch a court case. Because, you know, what were ladies doing?
Yeah.
Raising kids, keeping the home, that kind of thing.
Or being prostitutes.
Yeah, that's it, according to yesterday's tour. But, yeah, you know, just kind of, they wouldn't have had to climb the stairs in those big dresses.
Has it got a roof? Like the one last night?
Yeah. Yeah, because I guess there would have been a loft above there. Yeah,
yeah,
the, up there for storage and feed and stuff. Oh, handy. Okay. Uh-huh. Really handy. How clever. So did you say yours was still showing up?
Yeah.
Okay. About 10 minutes. Okay. All right. Let's break the horses out.
That's it. I was listening to the presentation to say, come on, you old man.
Oh, Jeffrey.
Why am I single? I don't understand.
Yeah, I think that was just residual heat from him.
Yeah, it must have been.
Yeah.
Well, I'm amazed how long it's held.
I know. One hardly dissipated in those, you know, 5 minutes or whatever.
Yeah, that's great. So it's not even like that wall's in direct sunlight.
No, it's not.
Where are we?
We're staying here.
Oh, okay, cool. Whatever. Let's do it. How beautiful it is. What a nice day. Yeah.
We walked past the tree. And he was asking about the tree. Obviously, I saw something in the tree. So when we came out of the stables, I was just literally just walking around the tree, just filming the tree. There were three bodies hanging from the
tree. Ooh. And it was super cold. I'm resuming my spot at the sergeant's seat. Thank you very much. I'm going to center the camera on you, superstar.
I say, feel free to have a walk through the books. Where was the
motor vehicle?
The logbook one.
Was the one with the cars?
That was the car one, that was the other.
I'm subtle listening, I got the pressure right now.
Attention. No calls from the public. Talking through some old.
You let your overcoat and then it gets returned as unserviced. And I love it.
Yeah, potentially from Melbourne, the Melbourne watch houses.
That's right.
What? Do you remember which page that was on?
I don't know. I didn't actually. I was just listening.
1965. Accommodation of mothers and families.
But there was an official record in the logbook of someone left the station on a Sunday. And it's like, okay. Another one in there was 64.
Oh, 64. Oh, there we go. Beatles, visit to Melbourne. Appreciation. No worries. I'm trying to figure out, because some of these are bail.
I suppose it would have been every sort of the day, wouldn't it?
Blood bank permission for attendance. Breathalyzer. Tests, procedure to be, don't know what that word is. So bail for prisoner, pentridge.
Past the tree, went up to the stables.
Yep.
And I could feel injustice, I could feel cramp, like a mob. It was almost like a
lynch mob sort of
lynch mob thing going on. But there was more than one, I feel, that was hung, maybe not that day, but overall. It was right when I walked past the tree, I said to my hubby, I'm getting images of someone hanging or people being hung there. Not maybe on that tree, but in the vicinity. Just the tree set it off somehow.
Just when you said that, I was thinking about what John was saying yesterday on Brockle Tour about the mob that went and trashed the hotels and all that sort of stuff. And sort of wonder whether that sort of ties in, because it seems like that sort of mentality.
Yeah, that's mentality. I was getting mobbed, but also in the mob, there's quite a few innocent people that were punished through this process, and could feel the innocence and the word injustice came to me in that. Where they sat.
Yeah.
Obviously, there was a lot of guilty there too, a lot of guilt, but there was a lot of innocence, a lot of innocent people.
I say it certainly seems, and once again, sort of on stuff that John said, where there's a lot of coercing of witnesses and judges as well.
And I felt the power of one man. If he made up his mind about you, he didn't care really what went on in the room, what was there, witnesses. He'd already made up his mind about you basically by some people's appearances,
yeah,
you were done for. That was the impression I got as well from one.
Yeah, for
one
sure.
Day.
Yeah, I sort of felt some more like it's almost like yeah, how unjust the justice
yes,
system is.
Yes, he had so much power. This one person, the power of who lived, who died, what happened with the rest of their lives, everything, and he actually thrived on that. He wasn't,
yeah, and
he
yeah,
wasn't
he,
good.
He abused it.
Oh, God,
yeah,
that was one man I got really strongly over in the courthouse. But that was, he's behind the mob hangings as well. I feel
yeah,
like he instigated the trouble
and
stuff.
Yeah, and sort of does the whole, no,
yeah,
no,
yeah, he actually
yeah,
kind of thrived on the energy of it. It's almost like he's the devil or something, dealing off him.
Because I've only got, I've only picked up one judge in there, which is surprising in itself because of how long a period it took.
Yeah.
I did Inglewood Courthouse a little while back, and there was more than one there.
Yeah.
But yeah, there's one
I'm
judge.
I'm picking up on that guy's bro. I think because he's so powerful, his energy's still there.
Yeah, yeah, he
yeah,
still owns that building.
Yeah, and he's
yeah,
still there. That's probably why I'm picking up on him this morning. It's the same, I don't know, but yeah, that's yeah,
yeah,
pretty bad though. You feel the heart rate of some of the people that were put in there. When I sat in that little box, my heart rate was
in the witness box.
Yeah, no, I just stood in the witness box, and from a witness perspective, I saw something, a murder, and my heart rate went up, and I was nervous and fearful, and like, I wanted to do the right thing, but I was too scared. And yeah, it was all going on in the witness box for me.
Yeah.
Before wandering around in the, where you're, is it defendant? You're the one that's going to on trial.
Yeah.
In the box. Once again, that fear. All eyes on you, judgment. You mean, no,
I was
that,
in the
yeah, no. Just before we were wandering around, I'm saying when the feelings you get, the energy, residual energy, it's still sitting
yeah,
in that box of all the different people that was made to sit there.
Yeah, it's
still sitting in that box.
Yeah, for me, in the defendant box,
yeah,
it was just very much a feeling of despair.
Yeah.
It wasn't guilt or I've been caught or anything like that.
No.
It was like, oh,
yeah,
I'm being
prisoned
for something I didn't do.
Yeah, I got that.
Yeah,
even in the walker, I felt someone really young, and I could hear the words, I didn't do it.
Okay.
Over and over, he kept saying, I didn't do it.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know whether it was really guilty or not, but he was saying it over and over.
Yeah.
Didn't do it.
Yeah, there was a woman in the witness box, and I've got to go back and.
Yeah, it's not.
Yeah,
I just came from
a
woman.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah,
she was mid-20s and was beaten repeatedly and so severely that cost her two children. And for a while, I was struggling to stand in the box. It was like,
I had the shakes in the first box, shakes.
Yeah, I was getting, she was showing me pain inside my body. It was from where I kicked her. I don't know whether it was pregnant, not by her husband or something like that, and it was the backyard abortion, so to speak, but it was horrendous, absolutely horrendous, and she was terrified.
This one I thought was seeing something or witnessed to something.
Okay,
yeah. And she was fearful of who the perpetrators were, and knew her. Must be a different story to yours, but amazing. Just picking up on the residual energy of emotions and stuff, pretty strong.
Yeah, I reckon I was that close to her actually talking through you. Like, if she wanted to, it was, and I was sort of like, like you said, there's so many people around.
Yeah.
That you sort of, it's hard to sort of center yourself, being surrounded by so many humans.
I actually could receive images of a murder though, as I was standing there.
Okay.
With not the shapes, the fear. Nerves, heart rate go up, all that. Then I started getting images like she was walking around a corner and she saw it happening, so she ducked back and was watching, and she saw a lady get murdered by this guy. It was a stabbing murder.
Yeah.
I think it's like a throat or something like that. It's horrible. So she saw it, but she stepped forward because she wanted to put a stop to all the violence, but then she realized she just put a big target on her back.
Yeah.
And she knew that she was not going to live long if she told the story.
It's funny because that's quite similar to mine. Like, she told me the thing, and then I got that within 6 months she was killed and thrown out of my shop. It felt like it was because she had seen someone, made someone else get put behind bars, and it was retribution for that.
I guess it's my hair, whether it's the same lady, but she had that fear of being killed for telling the story that she saw. She was hoping to do good. She was trying to make a change in her life, who she was. not be that person anymore, why she stepped up. But, she wanted a new life, but then she realised, because I felt she wanted in a prostitute because she didn't care.
Yep.
Really what happened to her. I was coming up with words that I'm not protected, I'm not going to be protected for what I'm doing here today. No one's going to look out for me.
Yeah.
Because no one cares. So no one cared whether she was dead or not. So she still stepped up.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, I had that feeling of wanting to run away though.
Yeah.
Overwhelm me. I had to get out of this box.
Yeah, it certainly makes sense for
that,
being that fear aspect
of it. It'd be lovely to hear the history of that. I mean, I'm sure they had a lot of cases that are similar at least, but yeah, to validate some of the stuff.
Yes.
I know it's a courthouse, and you know this stuff went on in the courthouse. It's actually get a real life story that was less close to what we've been seeing.
That's exactly right.
Nice.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that is Deb's incredible. The research that she came up with, it's insane.
When I first came into the defendant box, there was a feeling of anger, and I started coughing, like choking.
Yeah.
Me. And I heard the word bitch being thrown at me, and an image of someone getting strangled.
To go back in.
Well, maybe possibly murders, obviously. So like you say, just picking up different energies at different times. So I think the woman already said everything up for you.
We should look at heading back in soon. It's 2 minutes past two.
2 minutes past two?
Exactly. Adam's just given me a 5 minute call.
Yeah.
So.
Okay. Yeah, Deb did say 2 past 5 here, but
this is very calming in
here. It is. And yeah, like my impression the first time I came in here was there was a Sergeant Ray that was a career police officer here, died in 1949, and in the police residence which was next door, which is that one. I reckon it was him that I connected with him. I reckon he was one of those old school country coppers where if you did the wrong thing, it was and you knew you'd done the wrong thing, so you didn't do it again.
Yeah.
You know, not like in this day and age, you do the wrong thing, you get therapy. and so, but yeah, he was one of those firm but fair sort of things. That's the feeling I get off him. It's like, yeah, you knew that if I needed you to come down to the shop and see you, the cop shop and see me, you'd be like, oh, okay, I'm in trouble, but you knew you weren't good. He wasn't unjust, he wasn't unfair about it. It's certainly the way I sort of feel from it.
Although I have this feel a calming influence in here. Like, it's not frantic or negative, it's calming in here. That's how I would pick up in here.
I feel like not much in Dunolly at the time period from this police station would have been frantic. Because I think it seems like a fairly small town, you know, quiet little town. When it was a gold rush town, obviously, it would have been a whole lot more hustle bustle, go, go, go. But
having said that, talking to the locals when we first moved to Burnham, they were saying until the late 70s, you did not stay in Burnham overnight if you didn't live there.
Really?
Like it was a really rough and tumble.
Wow. We're talking to some of the locals here yesterday, and they were talking about how they would come here, like people moved here from the city and from other bigger sort of regional centres to escape the crime rate, because the average age here is quite old, you know, compared to a lot of other places. So, I don't know.
Yeah,
it would have been a halfway point.
It's about double the size of
Medivin. Really?
It's 500 in
Medivin. Wow, okay. Yeah. So there's 1,000 in Dunolly? Yeah, okay, about that. Yeah, cool.
It's the same thing. And that's why we moved there.
Yeah.
Just get away from Melbourne.
Yeah.
You're from Melbourne.
Yeah. It's originally about Mount Gambier and Cranbourne.
Yeah.
You moved to a country
town. Yeah. All right, we should probably.
Should Mosey back in over to the courtroom, maybe?
We've been given our 5 minute call to head back to the courthouse to finish up, so sorry, thank you. I like this cute little garden that they had to look out on. It's lovely.
So apparently the police residence was
there. Okay, cool.
Which sort of makes sense.
Why did they pull it down then? So unnecessary.
I think half the reason stuff gets pulled down around here is fires.
Oh, yeah, I guess.
Because otherwise, it doesn't seem to get left abandoned.
Yeah, which is sad.
Mm. Although it does make digging for stuff good. I couldn't leave Adam yesterday.
kleptomaniac yet with that bottle.
Yeah. I'll just wander over here. Oh, yeah, that's what I'm looking for.
That's what he does, though. He knows what to look for and...
50-year-old bottle.
Yeah. He knows what to look for and where to go and everything, so...
That's awesome.
It is awesome. He's found some really cool stuff. Come to our place for dinner one night. We'll get him to show you the collection. All right. Sorry? All right. Let's finish up the live feed.
So what we had before, we had two ladies on the other one. Now, I know one of them is definitely a psychic because I've actually used her at the jail, Angela. She was telling me a lot of stuff when we'd been in here earlier. So we come back in here. Now, what information that we've gotten by asking questions, there was a woman in here, and there was a man that was posted here for drunkenness, and he's actually raped her. So we've had everything going off in here, which we had live feeds, so you'll be able to go back and watch those live feeds like that. Okay, thank you. And I know you're not happy about what you did. You're actually quite disgusted in yourself, aren't you? A bit ashamed.
Does that mean something?
Aborted.
Interesting, isn't it?
Interesting.
Yeah, well, I just got there. I might write that one down. Yeah, I see scribbling here, there, everywhere on the back. I just
look.
Blood here.
Oh.
This is
blood here.
That's
gross.
Was there blood after the rape?
Okay.
Oh,
thank you.
That's why you can feel comfortable in here.
Mm-hmm. It's funny because some people can come in here and actually get the taste of blood. When there's blue blood, you know,
it was so dizzy, it was just...
Yeah, and it dizzy is all the energy that's in here, and he's got a lot of energy. She, when we come in here, she was actually a little bit quiet, but she wasn't too bad, but then he just took over.
And he's up everything.
Yeah, he's just eating up everything. Oh, we've got 3.2. Yeah,
that went to 5.
It went to 5? Yep, yeah. So we've got a millimeter reading there, 3.1.
That doesn't go off.
5.4. 5.3, 5.2, get into it.
Yeah,
alter
it.
Oh, whoa! Oh, that's a phone, because it's on a live feed.
There's another one.
Hand?
Hand.
It's
so
I bet
we're up
five.
To get 5, now it's dropping back down again.
Definitely got some to the surge.
Alright. Thank you for that.
Ask him if you wanted to see a priest.
So, the ghost meter here, now that's lit up a solid red, now it means he's there. When you ask a question, it's one flash for yes, two for no.
Okay.
So, ask him again.
Did you want to see a priest? One flash for yes, two flashes for no.
Yes. Do you want to confess your sins? No.
Oh, two flashes.
Are you okay?
Yeah. He got really angry then.
Yeah. Why do you want to see a priest then? Usually you like to see a priest because you want to confess. It's usually when you go to see a priest, or you're a bit scared about going over to the other side. Are you scared of what's going to happen over there? Maybe you're not going to heaven because of what you did.
Do you think it's too late? One flash for yes, two for no.
I just got 0.5.
0.12.
0.12. So there's a lot responding there.
Are you angry with us that we're in here? We want to help you, but for us to help you, you need to communicate with us.
Brutalized.
God. What was that?
Brutalized.
That's what, from the sounds of it, I reckon he's really done a doozy on her when he's raped her.
It's not some nice words to this guy.
Blood brutalized.
Hand.
Was she pregnant?
By his hand.
Well, abort.
Abort. Yeah.
So that could have been a possibility too. Maybe she was pregnant when he's raped her. She's aborted the baby.
It was, hence the blood.
Yeah.
That's
even the abortions back then were pretty brutal.
Yeah.
So. Everything
maybe she was pregnant. She had a really bad like delivery in this room, and if there was a delivery in here, we'd find that. There's no information on that.
We've got K2, we've got points.
And I doubt even back in those days.
Did that do a biopsy?
Gasp.
You
mean gasp? It's all kind of relative, isn't it?
Yeah.
To what's happened.
It's very one sort of.
He's trying to tell us something.
He
just said yes to something.
So ask a question, because if you ask questions, you might get responses. No, but you'll answer. Because if you didn't want to answer, you wouldn't be here setting things off. Exactly.
Did you know the woman...
Oh, wow.
Did you know the woman that you raped before you were in here?
Yes. Was she a prostitute?
He didn't almost want to answer that.
Yes.
That doesn't give you the right to rape her, though. No, it doesn't. She's not your play toy. You pay for a service, and that doesn't mean rape.
I didn't like that.
Was she someone that you liked to spend time with?
I think that KT's given a false reading too.
So we got them both at the same time.
You may have answered with that. So what was the question that you asked?
Was the lady that you raped, was she someone that you liked to spend time with?
By setting that off, that was probably a yes.
Element?
Did you get
anything? It just said element.
Okay.
See, all that stopped and the mum has gone down to...
See, even mum has gone down to virtually nothing now.
Yeah.
Coming back.
How they put men and women in the cells together, like they did a deal with the, with the
See,
police.
Nowadays, that would never happen.
Yeah.
But back
that's
then,
the first thought to come to that. Back then, that thought didn't come to.
Yeah.
Even though supposedly, church and state were so much closer together and there was that morality.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It wasn't expected or thought about.
We're quite often prostitutes.
Yeah, exactly. Like in the brothel tour yesterday, the things that you hear.
Yeah.
And even husbands had their wives being prostitutes, so it didn't matter, So.
But yet they segregated them in hotels.
Yeah, exactly. Mm. Oh, you're back.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's funny because that clicked on and then I heard that.
Did you
get a word on
there. No.
Oh, now it did. Clock, it says.
Clock.
Oh. Yeah.
What, you're watching the time.
I've already checked the time.
Yes.
Yes.
He's watching the time.
I'm watching the time too.
Why?
I guess if there's anything that he wants to tell us, he's probably aware that there's limited time.
Yes.
Mm.
No.
No. No.
So have you got plenty of time in the world to tell us? Yes, okay. Were you incarcerated for more than 5 years for what you did? More than,
was it just on 5 years?
More than 10 years. Two years.
That's what I was thinking.
Maybe 3 years. Or is it 21 years?
This is moving.
Can you beep how many years you were put in here for, into jail for? The one with the big stick on it? Can you make it beep singly and tell us how many years you were in here for? Is that there?
Life.
Contain.
No, that was there. No. Something.
She said more than 5 years. I reckon he meant 5 years, not more than 5 years.
He just did five.
Did you think it was more than 5 years?
I don't think it was more than five. It could have been 5 years or less.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I would say back in those days they wouldn't get sentenced for long for something like that.
Mm.
It just be five. Just it was exactly 5 years and stuff.
Yep. So is it 5 years?
But he must have done something wrong to be in here in the first place.
He was drunk.
Well.
Drunk.
Also, it was just because he was drunk.
Yeah.
He tried to use that as an
excuse.
But he was drunk. And he shouldn't have been put in there with a...
victim blaming him back then.
That was that was his fault.
Yeah.
That was their fault for putting a drunk man in with a woman. Well, that would have been her fault as well.
Yeah.
So we stay where we are and the groups just wander around.
That's what
all
we've
right.
done so far,
isn't
it?
That's
so.
It, yeah.
Well, that was interesting.
Definitely.